Ricardo to speak. From there, I go for a week to Boston. I've never been there. And speak to 6,000 university students for 1 week. Now, I'm not saying this to you to show and prove to you I'm a nice guy. I love to do things and then pretty boastful. I'm an important man. That's not the point. The point is that we all need to be willing to be used by the Lord. You see, I hesitate to come and work and speak with the average Estonians because I enjoy working with people who don't know the Lord is. On Tuesday I landed in Dhaka. That same night I went and spoke at Sonargao Hotel to a bunch of Rotary Club members and coming back next February to speak at a Rotary Convention. But anyways, then I talk about the Lord, you know, I quote from the Bible, from this Muslim folk and Hindus, I'm quoting from the Bible and they just, you see, and our job is really not to work among Christians alone, we need to be speaking and working with the Muslims and Hindus. In December, I go to Tanzania to do the same work. What if all of us are doing this? You see? So especially young people. You see, again, I'm the pastor's son and I wanted to be a physician because I wanted to work among people who don't know the name of the Lord. The best way to do is to be a physician and then I have the right to work with Hindus and Muslims or whoever else because I'm their physician and I can talk with them. So young people, you know, we don't know how long the world is going to last. You aim very high. It's a very, very high. And you pray for the Lord's blessings. Listen, we have the most wonderful message ever entrusted to any human being. And our past as a movement, forget the church. The church is corrupt. It's going to always be corrupt. We're a movement. You see, the movement is pure, it has been pure ever since the Lord left this earth. So we need to be members of a movement, a Seventh-day Adventist movement. I know before long some of you are not going to like me, but so what? See, the Adventist medical, okay, talking about the Adventist medical work, past and present and the future, but it has been a part of the movement. You see, Gopalganj Hospital was established in 1906. Loma Linda University Medical Center was established in 1910. What has happened? Today they are building a $1.3 billion hospital. And we have no medical work. And we have very little medical work in this country. But one of your big officers was in Loma Linda and I asked her, I said, why didn't you send 10 students from your church, from the church to medical schools here in this country? And I didn't like the answer, but anyways, he said, no, we cannot do that. So, we don't have the vision. The Lord says, because of the lack of vision, my people perish. Well, if you, who are leaders, if you don't have a vision, you might build churches like this again and again. We're not going to go too far. We have to be people of vision. We have seen this in this country. The Adventist work has been preached for 110 years. How many more 110 years are we going to be here, right? Anyways, medical work. In the mid 1800s, the good Lord formed the movement in existence that will proclaim to the dying world the message of hope and love. Message that encompasses the physical, mental, and social and spiritual aspects of one's life. A message to restore in man the lost image of his maker. How beautiful. What if this church had 50 doctors? Hey, another chapter of it, what there was only dentist, there is only nurse before. That will change the picture of happiness of here. Why is it not happening? Why not? Who is responsible? You know, we have to think about it. And I'm speaking to you young people. You know, don't be satisfied with whatever, you know, aim very high, because it's not for you, it's for your Lord that you serve. You still want me to speak or shall I sit down? Huh? Did you want me to speak?
Go ahead.
Okay. In the 1800s, it's the mercury is a relative of brain value. What is mercury? This is the doctor's use. That in 1800s, mercury is a poison that kills people. You see, that is called the brain value. Opium. Opium in Bangladesh?
Gaza.
And the council of Gaza PhD, but anyway, you don't know that stuff. It is opium is the most important drug, huh? And it should be employed in all kinds of treatments. Horrible. This is the media in 1800s. During this time, Our job is not to conquer. Our job is to go and there will be many people who are going to be in heaven who have never gone to church. He said, that's what we did. He said, Lord, what's in your hand? What's this mark? These people may not ever know who the Lord is. So let's not kid ourselves and say how we will get converted. That's not our job. Now, Ellen White, I want that for you to read this. This is important. Read this. The time will soon come when there will be no safety in people like the net. In eggs, milk, cream, butter. Because the disease in animals is increasing in proportion to the increase of wickedness among men. The time is near when, because of the iniquity of fallen race, the whole animal creation will groan under the diseases that curse the earth.
I'm in Jolly Bird.
So I was in Jolly Bird and all vegan. Though there was no meat and no eggs and no cheese. Okay. And I'm still a vegan. Still a vegan. I'm telling you, when you drink milk, এখন আমাদের অ্যাডভেন্টিস্টদের মধ্যে হার্ট অ্যাটাক হয় না and ক্যান্সার হয় এগুলো বেশি হইতেছে মানুষের স্ট্রোক হয় কেন
আমাদের
জীবন আর আমাদের চার্চ এই চার্চ ইফ দ্য চার্চ ইজ স্পেন্ডিং অল দ্য মানি টু পে ফর অল দ্য মেডিকেশনস অন অল দ্য ইলনেস উইল লিসেন টু মিসিং দ্য পয়েন্ট ইউ সি উই হ্যাভ টু রিয়েলি ট্রুলি টেক কেয়ার অফ আওয়ার ওন সেলফস এন্ড গো অ্যাট দ্য লর্ডস ওয়ার্ক অল রাইট কার মুখে জল আসতেছে এখন কার মুখে জল আসতেছে Okay, what does Ellen White say? What does Ellen White say? Jesus should never be introduced into the stomach. How did she know 150 years ago that cheese was not good for us? I think at the time, I'm telling you, the nutritionist of Cornell University wonders how did Ellen White, and she's not an Adventist, you're not even a Christian, he wonders how did Ellen White know 150 years ago about this medical principle? You think the Lord used her? If we're convinced that the Lord used her, we need to listen. It's not enough to know in theory, we have got to practice it. I'm telling you, one out of every two caskets, casketed Bangladeshi, this is that, casketed Bangladeshi. Kabore darshmai gubako, na? Kabore darshmai bakshe, ami je deshe thaki, duita jodi baksha hoy kabore baksho, ekta holo heart problem and infarct and stroke. One out of two Americans die of stroke. One out of two Americans die of cardiovascular disease. That includes heart attack and stroke. Okay. One out of every four Americans dies because of cancer. How about here? Amader deshe cancer beshi hoyeche na komar kese? Ha? Up or down?
Up.
Okay, how about heart attack? Up or down?
Up.
How about stroke? Up or down? not come here anymore, which is fine with me, but you know, we have to face the reality. There are three kinds of diabetes, type 1, type 2, and prenatal diabetes. Type 1 diabetes, it can take much of the diabetes. One out of every 10 person is type 1 diabetes. It's directly related to milk. Okay, directly related to milk. And let me tell you, you might be wondering, what is this man saying? The milk has protein in it, right? Okay, protein is made of amino acids. Okay, there are 20 amino acids that make our protein. Now, there's a sequence of amino acids in the milk. It's exactly the same as the sequence of amino acids in the islet of Lebanon that makes insulin. Exactly the same sequence. Now, when little baby is given the cow's milk, I want you to eat this. যখন মা বাচ্চারে গরুর দুধ দেয় কিছু সামটাইমস স্মল পিসেস অফ দ্য অ্যামিনো অ্যাসিডস ব্রেক্স অফ অ্যান্ড ইটস অ্যাবসর্ব ইন দ্য ব্লাড ওকে ওয়েন ইটস অ্যাবসর্ব ইন দ্য ব্লাড দি ইমিউন সেলস রেকগনাইজ দিস অ্যাজ অ ফরেন সাবস্ট্যান্স সো হোয়াট হ্যাপেন্স The body attacks it with antibodies. Okay? The same sequence, if it's the same as sequence of amino acids in the milk protein, if it's the same as the one in your pancreas, the same antibodies made by our immune system goes and destroys the pancreas, pancreatic islets of Langerhans, okay, of this little baby, and destroys all the Langerhans cells. Insulin. So before long, the baby is dependent on insulin for the rest of the baby's life. This is medical science. This is what goes on. So you see, cow's milk is for the is it for the baby or for cow's milk is for cow? After the week, I can see it. Okay. So, see it. Zebra day ki zebra milk day na cow's milk day. Huh? Zebra. The zebra gets zebra milk. Because these are all species specific. Okay? You cannot eat the zebra cow's milk. Okay. There are 4,700 different mammals in the world. Shayad hazar. There's only one mammal that drinks milk after it's weaned from the mother's breast. That mammal is called us, human beings. But we don't drink mother's milk, we drink cow's milk and we pay the price. Big time. Cancer would not be there so much had it not been for. Heart attacks would not be there so much had it not been for. Strokes would not be so much, even in this church. Had it not been the same. So we have to be very careful. We have to choose between eating what the Lord gave us in Genesis 1:29. You have the Bible. You can read it in Bangla or Orange, no? Bangla, in the Bible, Bangla, no? For the Orange, Genesis 1:29.
এক অধ্যায় 29 পদ ঈশ্বর আরও কহিলেন, দেখো আমি সমস্ত ভূতলে স্থিত যাবতীয় বীজোৎপাদক ঔষধি ও যাবতীয় সবীজ ফলদায়ী বৃক্ষ তোমাদিগকে দিলাম, তাহা তোমাদের খাদ্য হইবে। বীজোৎপাদক ঔষধি এবং যাবতীয় সবীজ ফলদায়ী বৃক্ষ।
ফল আর বীজ, তারপর গম হতে পারে, না গম হতে পারে, দুধ হইতে পারে, দুধ লাগে না। তো ঈশ্বর আমাদের সৃষ্টি করার পরে আমাদের খাবার দিয়েছে, ফর আই গিভ ইউ ফ্রুটস নাটস এন্ড গ্রেনস টু ইট, রাইট? আমার স্লাইডে নাই, কিন্তু অন্য স্লাইডে আছে। যখন যখন মানুষ মাংস খাওয়া শুরু করেছে, তাদের জীবন এক্সপেক্টেন্সি কি হয়েছে? মেথুশাল কতদিন বেঁচে ছিল? 73 years, 72 years. How long did Solomon live? 63 years. Because they were eating meat 3 times a day. Alright. Shall I sit down? Wait down? Huh? No? Quickly here till tomorrow morning. No, I'm not going to do that. So, if you need, we follow the health rules, health principles, we could make every church a Christian lifestyle center. Is your church Christian lifestyle center? Yes or no? Yes?
Yes.
No? You get on the pastor's case. It's okay, I don't get mad at me. But you should. You should make this place lifestyle center. Okay? For the lack of vision, my people perish. We need to be doing that. Christian lifestyle center, but the believers will be active in each day of week, giving health lectures. Health lectures. We have to be convinced first before we can convince others. Alright? I could not stand here and speak if I were eating meat and eating cheese and eating pizza and drinking whatever. I could not do that. We have to be truthful. You see? We have to be truthful to ourselves. Alright. Giving health lecture, caring for the sick, holding cooking classes, growing vegetable gardens for possible. You still have this land, you have a lot of land in here. Okay. Running a vegan restaurant. Why don't we do it? Why don't we do it in Dhaka? Why do other people get us? You see, we can do that. Whatever is possible, touching the lives through his hands, there should be not only be teaching but actual work. And the experience of practice is so important. You ever heard of Hunza land in the Himalaya mountains? Anyone? In Hunza land, people used to live 130, 140, 150 years until they put a highway to Hunza land and they got all outside stuff and the lifestyle changed and they are no longer living. They were eating fruits, nuts and grains, a lot of apricots. Anyone heard about Nauru Island? Huh? Good for you. Nauru in the Pacific. Now people live long. They have gardens in there. They ate fruits, they ate some fish. Okay, and they live very healthy. Well, something bad happened. They found phosphorus in the country, in the island. Lots of phosphorus. And the Europeans came there, the Americans came there, the Australians came there. For long, every Nauru member got on welfare. They started to get money from the government. Everyone. So they stopped working. What happened? they started Pizza Hut. আমাদের এখানে আছে Pizza Hut আছে। তুমি বলো Pizza Hut? আরে তুমি গোগা টু Pizza Hut? আই হোপ সো। নো। We have fun. We should have fun. But you know, I'm going to tell you, you women, you can come down with the ovarian cancer, and it's directly related to how much pizza you eat. So be very careful. I don't have the time to go into that, but I could get you still up. Okay? Be very, very careful what you choose. You know, your wife was right 150 years ago. Cheese should never enter the human stomach. By the way, you can make vegan pizza and it tastes good. If you don't believe it, someday maybe I'll have the time to make it here. You can. Alright, so they found phosphorus and everything changed. They got on welfare. So they have Pizza Hut now. They have cheeseburgers. They have, you know that little sign, big sign, it says that you have it in this country? McDonald's? Right? At the office? You want McDonald's to be here? No, I'm so glad to see that. No. Okay, so all these places want that. Now listen to me, this is important. Within 40 years, 45% of Nauru people became type 2 diabetes. Within 40 years, there was no diabetes before in the country. Really, I hope no one here has type 2 diabetes. You need to listen to what the Lord says when He created us. Genesis 1:29, for I give you food, snacks, and bread. Try to do that for 3 months, your diabetes is going to be gone. I can assure you, if it does not, let me know. And it's going to be gone. And maybe the church can save some money. Any idea what this is? Yeah, this is a lengthwise cut of a human artery. Okay. Okay, how nice and clean this one is. This is newborn. Baby died of whatever, they got the aorta, pretty open. Nice and clean, this opening, but small arteries go out, nice and clean. Teenager. If you are teenagers here, and you go to Pizza Hut, okay? And if you go to, what else here? Cheeseburger, Burger King. I don't want to see the thread going this way. She should not know. Okay, go there. This is how it starts to look. And then even going more, 40 years, this is how it looks. Does not look too healthy. Yeah? I am telling you, I've taken care of so what I've worked in the emergency room for 30 years. 20 years in Ohio, 10 years in California. The last 10 years in the Kaiser Hospital. You see, we sit patients having heart attacks 28 years old. You see? So we really have to be careful about what we eat. We have to be careful about what the Lord says here. It's not enough to come and preach or whatever. We should really be following what the Lord says in this book. Everything in your body, this is very true. We have 70,000 miles of blood vessels. And you know, today I spoke to a bunch of dentists. You know, I left you one of these there. So this is how normally a blood vessel looks like, nice and clean, but this is not. This is the one that has atherosclerosis. Okay. And the clean one is still in the second floor of the clinic. But anyways, this is what happens. Then you men or even ladies, something excites you, you get mad, the blood vessel, APFN is shot into the blood vessel and it squeezes and it totally closes up this area in here and someone has died. No, your heart is a large as your fist. So this is where your heart, the main vessel comes from, this what I call anterior coronary artery, coronary artery. And if that area is blocked, you don't make it to the ER. And so many times they bring me dead patients on occasion, you could turn that patient around. But you know, more than 6 minutes, and most of the case times the case is over. 70 miles of blood vessels. I hope no one's blood vessel looks like this. And we should work towards that. That basically don't need to go away. What's this one in here? It's a racist monkey from Africa, okay? Dr. Stemler, the researcher in Northwestern University in Chicago, a monkey that had hospital covered visit. He fed his monkey hospital food for 19 months. And at the end of 19 months, the poor guy died of. Poor guy died of a heart attack. 19 months of eating hospital food. So what's the lesson do we get out from there? The lesson we should get out is don't stay in the hospital for 19 months, right? The course not. We need to change our lifestyle. If you want to produce coronary artery disease in monkeys, all you have to do is to feed them average hospital food. And I don't think our hospitals can be any different than other places of the world. Anyone knows who this lady is, the man is? Anyone? Okay, let me tell you about this man. He went to Sergei Grigov, four-time world champion figure skating, okay? Twice Olympic champion figure skating. He was practicing in New York, and he had his wife on top of his head, and he dropped her. 28 years old, died in the ring of a heart attack. So he was in very good shape. How could someone be in very good shape, exercise so much, and die of a heart attack? This is bad. We have bad coronary artery disease. So it's very important what we eat, not merely how much we exercise. Very important. We are what we eat. Alright. He was diet in optimum diet. Fat, 40-45%, optimum less than 15%. Sugar, 35, discontrol, less than 10, discontrol. How many of us drink soft drinks? Every bottle of soft drink you drink, you get 12 teaspoonful of sugar. Bad, bad, bad. Sugars, cholesterol, 500 milligrams, less than 60. So, after that, you can actually kill blood pressure. If you have high blood pressure, you stop using so much salt. All you need is 2 grams of salt. About less than half of 1 teaspoonful of salt. That's all you need per day. No more. So the more you go to McDonald's and the more you cook with more salt, this is the price you pay and your blood pressure goes up. Fiber, diet, you know, ekta dala chicken and pura. It's a dala called pura, U-R-E. It's very high in fiber, very kinds of fiber. We need more than 40 grams of fiber a day. But we get, people get about 10 grams. Water. How much water should we drink? Lot. Lot. At least 10, 12 glasses of water a day. Very important. I don't have the time to eat. In fact, the people who are obese, rather going to the doctor, going to the hospital to have coronary artery bypass, okay, surgery. So the night before, the anesthesiologist drew his blood and then what? I'm sorry, I cannot do this. Next slide. Looks pretty gruesome, huh? Pretty gross, but guess what happens? The same patient from the ER goes to the operating room. That's what happens. In fact, they stop the heart. There's a Bengali gentleman, some of you might know him. I was just talking with him in the Lone Indian University Medical Center about 3 weeks ago. And he is a very prominent doctor there. They stopped his heart, they could not stand it. They were about to give up. Happened twice. So this is no fun. Alright, so what's the problem? This is normal serum, and this is how his blood looked like. What did happen? What did he eat before he came to the hospital? Cheeseburger. How many of you are going to go and eat cheeseburger? Be very careful. Alright, this is what he ate. And that's how his blood looked like in no time. Yes, alright, I hope no one's mouth is watering when you see this. Alright, let's see if I can run this one. This is, by the way, a capillary, the tiniest blood vessel in the body. Watch the red blood cells moving. These are individual red blood cells.
Next slide, please.
how nice and smooth the red blood cells are moving. See, and how fast they're moving. This is for real, by the way. Just in the submucosa, right under the... this is someone who just ate a fatty meal. You see, these are again individual red blood cells going down. And some are in blocks and not moving at all. I can make it up. This is after someone ate some fatty stuff. Alright? This place totally stopped and about 10 hours after eating, it starts to go back to normal. How about body organ? Psalms 139, verse 15 and 14. Psalms 139, verse 15 and
14. কি চিন্তা 139 অধ্যায় 13 এবং 14 পদ। বস্তুত তুমি আমার মর্ম রচনা করিয়াছ, তুমি মাতৃগর্ভে আমাকে বুঝিয়াছি। আমি তোমার স্তব করিব, কেননা আমি ভয়াবহরূপে ও আশ্চর্যরূপে নির্মিত। তোমার কর্মসকল আশ্চর্য, তাহা আমার প্রাণ বিলম্বন জানা। আমি তোমার স্তব করিব, কেননা আমি ভয়াবহ রূপে ও আশ্চর্য রূপে নির্মিত। ভয়াবহ রূপে ও আশ্চর্য রূপে নির্মিত।
এটি কি সত্যি আর মিথ্যা? একদমই সত্যি। এই রাও লিখেছেন কত বছর আগে,
প্রথম
Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Whoever destroys this temple, I'm going to destroy it. Wait a minute, but he's a loving God. That's what he says. Alright, I don't think you're lean beef in this country. But even if you eat, if you ate lean beef, you've got 29% of fat. But when you're eating the regular beef, you're getting 40-45% fat calories from there. Skinless chicken breast, 23% fat. Whole milk, Amritana Dukkai, 48% fat from the whole milk. Atlantic salmon, 40% fat. So let's be very careful. Anyone recognizes this couple? Anyone? Ever heard of the Beatles? This is Paul McCartney and his wife Linda. She died very early. She died 35 years of age and she ate nothing but vegetables. Why did she die of breast cancer when she was only 35? Why I didn't put the slide in there. She deep fried everything. Everything. I didn't have the time to talk about free radicals, but that's not the matter. She created cancer within hours and she died in no time. So when we deep fry stuff, please, you ladies, frying itself is not the best thing in the world. No, use very little oil. And don't deep fry so much. Alright. What is the best drink in the world?
Water.
Oh. water, so why do we drink whatever else? Huh? That's the question. I'm going to spend, are we done? Can I go a little bit long?
Yes.
This time it is not really true that you will like it. Because when I was in Jodhpur, we never knew what cha is, right? What tea is. I went for a week of prayer in our college in Pakistan in 2009. And every faculty home was drinking tea. And I was in that college a few years back, many years back. No one drank tea yet. No one. Now everyone is drinking tea and we're paying the price. But let's drink
water.
How much should we drink? Alright. 2 giraffes. This is the acacia plant. The giraffes love acacia leaves. But see, the thing is, they graze and they walk some, and then they graze again, and they walk some, and they graze. Why? I'll tell you why. You know? Okay, don't share. Okay, right. What happens is that when they start grazing, the tree knows that it's being attacked. Okay? So the tree releases a chemical called pheromone. That chemical gets out around the tree and around the rest of the trees nearby. Okay? And that pheromone says release tannin. So the tree releases tannin into the leaves and the leaves become bitter. So guy tastes bad, it tastes acrid. By the way, tea has tannin in it. So it walks several feet and it starts to graze again. When the tree realizes there's something wrong in here, it releases pheromone and the process goes on and on. And so they walk from tree to tree and they graze that way. You see? So the human beings found out this secret. What's this? Well, what's different about this place in here? What's on top? Is it up this way or is it flat?
Flat.
How about on the sides? Is it flat also?
Yes.
Yes, it is flat. So the ladies can walk through and bend and cut the tree leaf. What they do is they take a stick. They take a stick and then they go. This is how they chop off the mature leaves, okay? That's what this is the plan. At least that's what they do in Africa. So what does the tree realize? That something is attacking it, right? They don't take a knife or they don't take a clippers because they want a shearing effect, as if something was climbing and shearing off the leaves. What does the tree plant do? What does the tree do? The plant do? It releases caffeine. By the way, tea leaves have more caffeine than coffee. By the way, if you don't believe me, check it out. Okay. The tea leaves have more caffeine by weight than coffee. Alright, so when the milk trees release the plant releases the caffeine, where does it go? It goes to the smallest leaves, the budding leaves. And when these ladies pluck, what do they pluck? The big leaves or the small ones?
Small
ones. So when you pour, drink your tea, you're getting more caffeine than you normally would if they got the bigger leaves. Well, what happens to our bodies is that above our kidneys there are two glands. Do you remember the names of the glands? What are they called? They're called adrenals. Do duodenum, means kidney, and duodenum is sitting on top of the kidney. And it's that releases very powerful hormones. Without that, you cannot live. If it's too much, you cannot live either. It has to be exact amount. But when we pray, every time we drink the tea, the adrenals release mainly two hormones, epinephrine and cortisol. The epinephrine, before you drink the tea, if you have any one of you drink tea in here, before you drink your tea, you take your cups. After you drink the tea, about 5 minutes later, you take your pulse again. You think the pulse is going to be down or up? Up, right? Why? Because the adrenal has released epinephrine. That is a fight or flight hormone. So you're sitting there, you're sitting up there on the desk, you're doing the computer work and you're sipping coffee or tea. What are you doing to your heart? You're making it hard, work hard. Okay? The rate goes up. In addition to that, there are many other hormones that you can tanning or caffeine releases, but two main ones are cortisol and epinephrine. What does cortisol do? It's an anti-inflammatory, but it releases, it makes the liver release a ton of sugar. So your sugar level goes up. What does the pancreas do? It releases insulin to burn the sugar. So before long, your sugar level goes down and you want another cup of tea. So this process goes through the day. Is that normal?
No.
No. Are you hurting yourself? Yes. The Lord says, whoever will destroy this temple, I'm going to destroy you. So folks, thank you for your patience. I think that's the last slide I have, but maybe someday we can talk more. But we are absolutely fearfully and wonderfully made. We need to be very mindful of what we eat, what we drink, what we wear, how we think, what we watch, what we sing, what we read. Because we must do this to the glory of our Father. I'm convinced that we have very little time left. And we have to work, do the work. In one sense, we would like to do work, but we neglect it to do it good time. No, I quit working, I was making pretty good money, I never counted how much I was making. I quit working in 2015, and this is what I do, full time. No, I encourage all of people. I really didn't want to come. I think I'm a bad attitude. I didn't want to come. I said the whole day I worked, maybe I was going to go, and tomorrow I'm speaking again. So, but I'm here, and hope you have learned something. If you did not, at least you have in your heart a desire to read more on this and really make changes in your lifestyle. But if I have been able to touch one life, I'm thankful to the Lord that I've been used this evening. May the Lord bless you and may you be willing to accept the blessing for us to dedicate ourselves every day to His service, so that He may glorify Himself in our lives.
Amen.